April is National Distracted Driving Awareness Month. According to a report from the Iowa Department of Transportation, distracted driving caused 11 car accidents in Oskaloosa last year. 9 of those led to injuries. 1 was serious. I talked to an Oskaloosa Police Lieutenant and a local resident to find out why it's important to stay focused behind the wheel.
That morning I came to the intersection. The light was red and I stopped waiting for the walk sign to change.
Oskaloosa resident Keith Miller was walking home from the YMCA a few months ago. He had to cross the street here at the corner of A Avenue and North 3rd Street.
And the walk sign changed and I went to step out in traffic and the car came from the east to make a right-hand turn and the light was red. But the driver never stopped.
Miller says the driver was talking on a cell phone. The
driver never saw me. If I would have stepped out there, I would have been hit.
This was the most recent encounter Miller had with a distracted driver, but it wasn't the first one.
They put on mascara, they put on lipstick, they drink coffee, they light cigarettes, they play in the cell phone. They playing with the radio.
Oskaloosa Police Lieutenant Craig Alexander says Miller's concerns are valid.
You know, distracted driving is increasing. There's a lot of technology that people are using. But also studies show that if you are using a cell phone or you're distracted, you're 6 times more likely to become involved in an accident.
Iowa law bans drivers from texting while driving. If you're caught, you'll be fined $30, and you'll pay closer to $100 after surcharges and court fees. Teen drivers aren't allowed to use cell phones at all, but the laws are hard to enforce. It's not always obvious to police officers whether an adult driver is legally dialing a number on their cell phone or illegally sending a text message. But Alexander says just because it's legal to drive and talk on a cell phone doesn't mean it's safe.
Just pull over. Like you're supposed to. The law says you're supposed to pull off the roadway and come to a complete stop. Then you can take your phone call or you can text or whatever you need to do. But
back at the intersection of A Avenue and North 3rd Street, Miller says he's trying to make drivers more aware.
I've written some letters to the editor before, and I've written letters to the legislators.
And he hopes raising awareness will make a difference.
One reason I'm doing this because it might save somebody's life, it might save my life.
If you'd like to learn more about the dangers of distracted driving, visit www.distraction.gov.
According to a study from the University of Utah, using a cell phone while driving, even if it's a hands-free one, delays your reaction time as much as having a 0.08 blood alcohol level. That's the legal limit.